Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. This is Evangelist Brenda Thompson coming to you today. Today I greet you in no other name than in Jesus' mighty name. The title of my message to you today is More Than Just the Carpenter. My message is taken from Mark chapter 6, verse 1 to 6, and Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6 and 7. And he went out from thence and came into his own country, and his disciples followed him. And when the Sabbath day was come, he began to teach in the synagogue. And many hearing him were astonished, saying, "From whence has this man these things? And what wisdom is this which is given unto him, that even such mighty works are wrought by his hand? Is not this the carpenter, the son of Mary, the brother of James and Joseph and of Judah and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us?" And they were offended at him. But Jesus said unto them, "A prophet is not without honor, but in his own country, and among his own kin, and in his own house." And he could hear, do no mighty work, save that he laid his hands upon a few sick folks and healed them. And he marveled because of their unbelief. And he went round about the villages teaching. Please turn with me to Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6 and 7. "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform it." Father, I come to you today in Jesus' mighty name. I pray in the name of Jesus that this message will be a blessing to all those who hear it, Lord, in the name of Jesus. History records in Matthew chapter 1, verse 18 to 25, and Isaiah will record in Isaiah 9, 6, also in Isaiah chapter 61. Concerning who Jesus is. In verse 1 to 6, speaks about Jesus' ministry and his beginning and the end of his ministry in Nazareth. Mark chapter 1, verse 9 to 11 and 21 to 20. In verse 1, Jesus' ministry with his disciples is spoken about. In verse 2, speaks about Jesus' doctrine and his miracles. In verse 1 and in 2. "And he went out from thence and came into his own country, and his disciples to teach in the synagogue, and many hearing him were astonished, saying, from whence had this man these things? And what wisdom is this which is given unto him, that even such mighty works are wrought by his hand? In verse 3, speaks about the spirit of rejection. Today I would like to draw your attention to Isaiah chapter 50. Who had believed our report, and to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of a dry ground. He had no form, no comeliness. And when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrow and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed, and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearer is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment, and who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living, for the transgression of my people was he stricken. In verse 4, Jesus responds. But Jesus said unto them, a prophet is not without honor, but in his own country, and among his own kin, and in his own house. In verse 5 and 6, speaks about the spirit of rejection. Hallelujah. And he could yet do no mighty work, save that he laid his hand upon a few sick folk and healed them. And he marveled because of their unbelief. And he went round about the villages teaching. Whose report will you believe today? Who is this Jesus? In Isaiah 53, it expresses who Jesus is. In Philippians chapter 2, verse 5 to 11, let this mind be in you, which also was in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men, and being found as a man. He humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God also has highly exalted Jesus and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, witchcraft and witches, and every principality and power, every throne and every kingdom shall bow to the name of Jesus, and that every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah. Glory be to Jesus. In Matthew chapter 16, verse 13 to 19, expresses who Jesus is. In Revelation chapter 1, verse 7 says, behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him. In Revelation chapter 21, Jesus is spoken about through the kingdom of heaven. In John chapter 3, verse 1 to 7, speaks about Jesus. Are you saved today? Have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Hallelujah. Today, I would like to lead you into the sinner's prayer. And I would also like to pray the blood of Jesus Christ for your healing, for your deliverance, and salvation. Today, I would invite you to invite Jesus into your life. You must be born again. Hallelujah. You must repent of your sin and be baptized in the name of Jesus for the remission of your sin. Today I would like to pray the blood of Jesus Christ over your life, for your salvation. But today I want to say to you, if you're not saved, you must be born again. You must invite Jesus Christ to come into your life. For the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus for your deliverance, for your healing, for your marriages, for every situation and every circumstance that has brought shame and reproach to your life, that has brought defeat and sorrow. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, I plead the blood of Jesus over your finances, over your marriage, over your hope, against the spirit of hopelessness today. I plead the blood of Jesus to bring restoration and to bring healing and to bring joy and peace and deliverance and healing. I plead the blood of Jesus right now. I speak the blood of Jesus in the atmosphere against every principality, against